إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، اتقوا الله أيها المسلمون حق التقوى، واستمسكوا من الإسلام بالعروة الوثقى، واعلموا أن أجسادكم على النار لا تقوى. قال تعالى: واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. My brothers and sisters, mankind has been created by its Lord in order to worship Him Jalla wa Ala. There is no other objective of our existence. The reason why we have been created and been placed on earth is so that we will spread goodness upon the earth and prepare for our hereafter. This is why every single man and jinn has walked the face of this earth. And even our fitrah tells us that we all need to be good human beings. This is something that Muslims and non-Muslims will recognize alike. Every single one of us have a desire to be good. But it's unfortunate, my brothers and sisters, all of this is changing and a lot of the fitrah has been changed. People don't know what their objective is anymore. And this tells us, my brothers and sisters, that the hour and the end is near. The purpose of our existence is about to close. The hour is close. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who came over 1,000 years ago, came as a warner. And he told us sallallahu alaihi wasallam that the fitna and the corruption after he leaves the dunya sallallahu alaihi wasallam will only get worse. In actual fact, when he was alive, he was scared for himself and his ummah that the hour would be established even whilst he was alive sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's how close he felt it was, but it wasn't. And before he left sallallahu alaihi wasallam, your Prophet and your Messenger has left you with a message, and he is giving you a description, and he has told you what to look out for. He has told you that there are certain things that you need to prepare for, and if you see them, then know that the end is near and the earth is about to end. And this is from the wisdom and the mercy of Allah Jalla wa Ala, that the end doesn't happen all of a sudden. Allah doesn't get angry with us and punish us all of a sudden. He gives us signs so that we can think, signs so that we can return to our fitrah, signs so that we can think again about our purpose in life and the objective of our creation. And if we are not fulfilling those signs, if we are not fulfilling that objective, the signs are given to mankind so that we can think and make tawbah to him before it's not too late. My brothers and sisters, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that there are many signs. He said that killing and war will spread. He said a lot of people will become materialistic. He said materialistic people will spread and there will be more wealth on earth. But at the same time, whilst having more wealth, you will find people becoming even more stingy and becoming even more mean. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La taqumu as-sa'ah," the hour will not be established, "hatta yakuna as'ad an-nas bid-dunya," until the most happiest person in the dunya will be the Luq ibn Luq. And the ulama have explained that the Luq ibn Luq is the person who doesn't know anything, the person who has no ambition in life, the person who doesn't even work. He's not worked a day in his life. He doesn't have any ambition to do any labor work. He has no ambition to learn and educate himself. But he is given the dunya. He is given everything from the dunya. He is given clothes. He is given cars. He is given wealth. And this person, the most ignorant of people, will become the most happiest people. This is a sign that the hour is about to be established. He told us sallallahu alaihi wasallam that people will display their bodies and their bodies will become apparent. People's aura will become uncovered. He told us sallallahu alaihi wasallam the hour will not be established until greed will spread. The hour will not be established until obesity will spread. The hour will not be established when people will question the existence of their Lord, the existence of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Ignorance will spread. He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "wa yuntiq fiha ar-ruwaybida," But despite not having any knowledge, the Ruwaybida are those people who will speak about all affairs. The most ignorant of people, but they will talk about the religion, and they will talk about politics, and they will talk about everything. And this will affect the life. This will affect the lives of all of the people on earth. This will affect the stability of all of the countries on earth. And because of this, my brothers and sisters, corruption will spread, trust will be lost. And the Prophet ﷺ even told us that the physical nature of this dunya will even change. The dunya, the earth that we know, won't even look the same anymore. Even the weather will change. The Prophet ﷺ said, the hour will not be established until earthquakes increase, eclipses increase, landslides increase. And all of this is happening in the dunya as we speak right now, my brothers and sisters. But he also told us, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that the actions of mankind will change. Mankind, every single one of them, will become normal to zina. It will become normal riba. Music will be everywhere. The hour will not be established until people are addicted to music, people are addicted to drugs, people are addicted to alcohol and intoxicants. And today, my brothers and sisters, our children, not even just our children, even our adults, they are not only addicted to signs, they are not only addicted to sins, but they are also engaging in major sins. But not only are they engaging in these sins, but these people have a love for the signs of the hour themselves. These people, despite saying La ilaha illallah, have become, because of their weakness in man, the signs and part of the signs of the hour being established. They themselves are loving and watching the signs happen in front of them, and they are taking part in them. These signs, my brothers and sisters, are plenty around us. People are loving and watching the appearance of one eye. People are loving and watching and even taking part, despite saying La ilaha illallah, in shaitanic rituals, in the show of zina, to people taking other people's wealth unjustly. And they themselves have become part of the hour being established upon mankind. The Prophet ﷺ told us, my brothers and sisters, that people, once it gets so bad, the signs, it will increase. But there will be some signs that will come, and if they haven't made tawbah before those signs, then there will be no turning back. Their tawbah will not be accepted, and the signs will increase and increase, and there will be no rectification left for mankind. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Thalathun idha kharajna la yanfa'u nafsun imanuha lam takun amanat min qabl aw kasabat fi imaniha khayra." And he mentioned from them the coming of the Dajjal. My brothers and sisters, the greatest of all of these signs and the first one to appear from the major signs is the appearance of al-Masih al-Dajjal. This is the greatest fitna that this earth has ever seen. And in fact, the Prophet ﷺ has also told us to warn us that Ad-Dajjal is going to be the greatest fitna, but despite that, he is already alive. And he wants to come out. And he asks to come out. And he has met one of the companions and he asked about the signs that is happening in the outside world so that he can come out. And when he is released, the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّمَا يَخْرُجْ مِنْ غَضَبَةٍ يَغْضَبُهَا. When he is released, because he has been locked up for so long, because he has been prevented from spreading his fitna for so long, he will come out and he will be released and he will be furious with mankind. Al-Masih al-Dajjal. My brothers and sisters, the fitna of the Dajjal, there is nothing worse that this dunya has ever seen. No war, no corruption, no major sin. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ma bayna khalqi Adam ila an takun as-sa'a fitnatun akbaru min fitnati ad-dajjal." There is no sign, there is no fitna, there is no corruption that has ever happened from the time of Adam until the last time, until the hour when it is established, except that the fitna al-Masih ad-dajjal is the worst. He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Ma min nabiyyin illa qad andarahu qawma." There is no nabi from the time of Nuh until the last prophet, except that that Nabi has warned his nation about Ad-Dajjal. He told them about Dajjal. He described Ad-Dajjal. He told them about the fitna and he told them to stay away. My brothers and sisters, the appearance of the Dajjal is something which is important to our iman, because it tells us that mankind now, as the signs begin to appear and spread, are moving towards the anger of Allah. More sins have spread on earth. More signs are spreading of the hour being established. And when bad outweighs good, this shows us, my brothers and sisters, that Allah is becoming more angry at mankind than having mercy on them. We are moving towards a day when Allah will be angered in a day that He has never been angered before, Jalla wa Ala. My brothers and sisters, who is this Dajjal? And what are some of the signs of him being released? And what will he do when he comes out? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and this is the time that we're living in right now. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, before the coming of the Dajjal, there will be 3 years of extreme poverty. خرج الدجال ثلاث سنوات شداد يصيب الناس فيها جوع شديد. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us that there will be an economic crisis. There will be an environmental crisis. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the first year will be a year of starvation, and then the years that come after that, the following 2 years, will get worse and worse. Food will reduce to the extent that there won't be even enough drinking water left for mankind to benefit from. My brothers and sisters, some of the scientists and the experts have said within the next 30 years, here in the UK, one of the most advanced countries in the world, here in the UK, within the next 30 years, there won't be enough drinking water left for the population to benefit from. This is despite us being an island and surrounded by water. Within the next 30 years, there won't be enough water for us, all of us, to drink and benefit from. My brothers and sisters, the word Ad-Dajjal means that he is a liar. He is an imposter. And this tells us what he will be and what he will do and what he will look like. He will appear and he will be a very young man. He will be a very strong man. He will be a very built man. He will have a tanned appearance. He will be short and he will have thick curly hair. His right eye will be blinded as if it is wiped over by skin. And the eye that is coming out from his right eye will be protruding. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described it as if it is a grape coming out of the socket of his eye. He will be impotent. He will not be able to have children. But why is this a lie? And why is this important to us, my brothers and sisters? He will claim to be Allah himself. He will claim for rububiyyah for himself. But all of this shows his imperfection. He is short. He can't have children. He only has one eye. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, your Lord has no imperfection. So be firm. In between his eyes will be a sign for the believers, and it will be written kafara. And every single person who says La ilaha illallah sincerely, whether they can read Arabic or not, will be able to distinguish that this man is the Dajjal, and they will be able to read those letters in between his eyes. My brothers and sisters, today there is a loss. There was a great deal of loss that is happening in the East. Every single one of us is worried about what is happening in the Middle East and in that region. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Al-Masih Dajjal will come from the East. He will come from amongst the fitna. And he will have an army of him. He will have an army with him of 70,000 people. They will be wearing crowns. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, my brothers and my sisters, my sons and my daughters, my fathers and my mothers. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, فَيَكُونُ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ يَخْرُجْ إِلَيْهِ النِّسَى. Most of his followers, most people who will flee to Ad-Dajjal as soon as they see him, will be women. To the extent that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, hatta inna rajul, a man will see the Dajjal, he will go back home, he will look for his mother, he will look for his daughter, he will look for his sister, and he will have to chain them up. He will have to chain them up because he will fear that they will go out and join Ad-Dajjal. But all of this is a lie because he is an imposter, my brothers and sisters. He will claim to be a prophet. He will spread fitna in the East. Then he will spread his fitna in the West. And then he will go back to Al-Hijaz because he will never be able to infiltrate Hijaz. And some narrations also say that he will not be able to infiltrate Al-Misr, Egypt, and Bahrain also. Once he will claim to be a prophet, people will believe him. Then he will claim to be your creator himself. He will claim to be Allah Jalla wa Ala. He will command mankind to worship him. And if you disbelieve, he will punish you. And he will give you proof to make him suggest and to make it seem as if he is speaking the truth, but he is a liar. He will bring proof that no technology has seen before and no magician has been able to accomplish before. He will command the sky to rain, fatumtir, and he will command the earth to bring out harvest, fatunbit. He will be able, from the permission of Allah, to command the weather to rain when there is starvation. He will command the earth to bring out food when people are poor and hungry. My brothers and sisters, people will meet him. He will give them the dunya and they will be happy with him. He will have two rivers with him. And he will say, enter the river which is of water or the river of the fire. And you have to choose. And he will make this as a fitna upon every single one from mankind. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, inna ma'uhu ma'um wa nara. He will have water and he will have fire. فَنَارُهُ مَاءٌ بَارِدٌ. For the believers, those people who disbelieve in him and recognize him as being a liar, they will enter into the fire, but it will be a peace and a serenity from the fitna with the permission of Allah. It will be a miracle given to those people who say La ilaha illallah. But those people who are fooled, those people who are tricked, will enter into the water, but it will be a fire and it will be corrupting for them. He will test them. He will test people. He will come up to people and he will say, believe in me, I have the ability to bring people back to life. He will have shayateen with him. He will have sihr with him. And a person will be approached by a dajjal and he will make his parents alive again. And his parents will be taken the form of shayateen. And the shayateen will tell the person, worship this man, he is your Lord. Worship this man, he has brought me back to life. My brothers and sisters, he will command mankind to worship him. He will command mankind to follow him, but he's impure. He is full of defects and he doesn't call to anything which is good. He is calling for a spread of corruption and a spread of lies. A fitna, my brothers and sisters, which has already begun. My brothers and sisters, the fitna when Dajjal, eventually when he comes, will be greater than what we can mention. The fitna will last not for a very short period of time. It will be extensive. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he will be in the dunya spreading his fitna for 40 days. And the first day will feel like a year. And the second day will feel like a month. And the third day will feel like a week. And the rest of the days will be normal. The fitna will be so great. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَلَقَدْ أُوْهِيَ إِلَيَّ أَنَّكُمْ تُفْتَنُونَ فِي الْقُبُورِ. You will be questioned in your graves. And this has been revealed to me. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this, مِثْلُ أَوْ قَرِيمٍ مِّن فِتْنَةِ الْمَسِيحِ الدَّجَّالِ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam likened the fitna of a Dajjal to the punishment and the questioning of the angels in the grave. My brothers and sisters, his coming is close. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, there is no group of people who have a religious belief except that they are waiting for a person to appear. People have already begun to prepare for the fitna. Some people have already started helping, spreading the fitna. And some people are already worshipping Ad-Dajjal. My brothers and sisters, the Quran connects us to our true Lord, the one who is free from all imperfection. And Allah over again in the Quran has a message for us and a message for mankind that prepare, believe in Allah and prepare to meet Him on the Day of Judgment. Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah said, Allah mentions in many places in the Quran belief in Allah and belief in the last day, because when a person is firm in his belief of Allah, he will prepare for the signs that are going to come and he will prepare for the reckoning when he stands in front of your Lord. So respond to Allah, my brothers and sisters, and His Messenger. This will give you life. Allah says in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَرَسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ يَحُولُ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَقَلْبِهِ وَأَنَّهُ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. If you return back to Allah and your religion, and you strengthen your iman, you will be protected from fitna. You will be protected from fitna. Because when the fitna falls, my brothers and sisters, it will escape no one. وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن والسنة. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. استغفر الله. الحمد لله Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala rasulillah, ma ba'd. My brothers and sisters, Dajjal will appear and his fitna will be great and his army will be great. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has also told us that goodness on this earth will remain. The people of Iman will remain. In an actual fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has told us that even the trees and the stones will support the people of Iman when the Dajjal will appear. They will say to him, they will say to the believer, Ya Muslim, هذا أدو الله ورائي فاقتلوه. The trees and the stones will speak to the people of Iman. But this can only happen, my brothers and sisters, if we understand who the people of Iman are. There can only be one group which are consistent until the hour is established, which are upon that right way. Just like Dajjal will come, and Dajjal is already here. Just like Dajjal has an army and they are preparing for him to come out, the people of Iman are already here. The people of Iman are already walking the earth. These people of Iman will be those people who will defeat Ad-Dajjal. But who are they? The ulama of Ahl Sunnah have said that they are At-Ta'ifatul Mansurah wal-Firqatul Najiyah. The Prophet ﷺ described them as being the safe sect who are already on earth. The Prophet ﷺ said, لا يزال طائفة من أمتي. There will always be a group of people from my ummah, ظاهرين. They will be apparent in their truth. They will be apparent in their methodology. They will be apparent in their iman and their actions. حتى يأتي أمر الله. Until the command of Allah comes, which is the signs of the hour. But no, my brothers and sisters, not just anyone can join that group. Not just anyone will be saved. Hassan ibn Atiyah, one of the imams of the Salaf, said, there will be a small number that will go out and confront the Dajjal. And it will be a very small number that will be victorious over him. In another narration, my brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that this small number will go through a lot of trials, but they will be firm in their iman. To the extent that they will go through starvation and they will go through poverty. So the companions asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَمَا يَعِيشُ النَّاسِ فِي ذَلِكَ الزَّمَانِ. How will they survive when they have little provisions? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, التَّهْلِيل وَالتَّكْبِير وَالتَّحْمِيد. They will say, لا إله إلا الله. They will say, Allahu Akbar. They will say, Alhamdulillah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that will give them sustenance, just like food would give them sustenance. My brothers and sisters, how can we say Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, and make dhikr of Allah when we don't know what it means? How can we be of those people from the safe sect when we are not learning about what Iman is and the meaning of the religion of Allah? In actual fact, my brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, no matter how pious you think you are, you will not be able to overcome the Dajjal. There was a man called Ibn Sayyad at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Umar thought, radiallahu anhu, that he was from the Dajjal. So he asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, let me go and kill him. Let me remove him from the earth so he cannot spread his fitna. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if he is a Dajjal, you will not be able to overcome him. Allahu Akbar, my brothers and sisters, not even Abu Hafs can overcome him. So how about ourselves? How about when our iman is weak? How about when we are falling in the signs of the hour ourselves, when our iman is weak and we don't know which group to follow and why we are following the religion of Allah? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on one occasion, he spent all day describing who the Dajjal is. And this teaches us, my brothers and sisters, that we need to go back in learning our religion so that we can be safe. We can go back to our religion so that we can know the meaning of our adhkar. We can know the meaning of la ilaha illallah. We can know the meaning of who Allah is so we can know who Allah isn't. And we can know the meaning of making dua and worshipping Him so that we can be safe. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhab jahannam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught his companions. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhab jahannam. This is something that we must all memorize. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this at the end of his salat. And some of the ulama have also said that it is wajib for us to make this supplication. Wa a'udhu bika min adhab al-qabr. Wa a'udhu bika min fitnati masih ad-dajjal. Wa a'udhu bika min fitnati mahya wa mamat. My brothers and sisters, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, "La yakhruj ad-dajjal hatta yathalu an-nas an dhikri." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that ad-dajjal will only come out when people are not talking about him anymore. Wa hatta tatruku al-a'imma, until the people on the minbars are not warning about the Dajjal anymore. This is because, my brothers and sisters, the fitna has become so widespread. We have to talk about other things rather than the Dajjal. So protect yourselves, return back to the religion of Allah. Remember that the fitna is real and it's already begun. And there's only a group of people that will be saved. And we have to join ourselves with them. But that can only come about if we strengthen our iman and we learn about who they are. اعلموا أن الله أمركم بالصلاة والسلام على نبيه قال تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر دينك وعبادك المؤمنين اللهم اجعل مجتمعاتنا اللهم اجعل مجتمعاتنا آمنا مطمئنا يا رب العالمين اللهم من أرادنا بسوء اللهم من أرادنا بسوء فأشغل في نفسه اللهم نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون